Did you know that 2.7 million messages of email are sent in just 1 second in the world? Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Hello Trust, your one-stop podcast dedicated to the world of digital trust, a set of innovative technologies that allows us to perform complex operations directly online, such as signing a digital contract, opening a bank account, or even subscribing an insurance policy. I'd like to remind you that this podcast has been produced by InfoCert, the largest qualified trust service provider in Europe, and you can watch all the episodes through our YouTube channel or even listening to it through your favorite podcast platform. As always, with me in this journey, Igor Marcolongo, a true guru in eIDAS 2.
Ciao Pasquale, thank you for having me, and so let's navigate this landscape of trust.
Today with us, Hector Benitez, a real expert of digital trust and especially eDelivery, part of one of the most important providers in Spain. Benvenido.
Ciao, thank you so much. It's a pleasure to be with you.
So let's start this episode talking about eDelivery. I know that over the years, different local standards have been applied to eDelivery. What is going to change with eIDAS 2?
Yes, it's true. You know, eDelivery was already present into eIDAS 1, and the different member states, different regions decided or not to design and to push on an eDelivery system. We have more or less two big configurations. The first one that is really important, is vital for Italy, for example, is the one based on email. In Italy, it is called PEC, Posta Elettronica Certificata. It is, simplifying a lot, an email system with mailboxes and a set of certification over it that permits you to know when a message has been sent, with a perfect time, if it has been delivered to a mailboxes, with everything is tracked and everything is certified. The other configuration is called the store and notify one. So it is a trust through interposition. What does it mean? That you have a third party in the middle of the communication that receive the communication and keep it and store it into a server, then notifying to the receiver that he has logically and electronically to come to that mailbox, central mailbox, to read the message. Everything, of course, is tracked, everything is certified, but it has a different configuration than the mailbox. What will happen with eIDAS 2? That there will be an implementing act that aims to try to create a common regulation, even from a technical and functional level, and maybe push the interoperability. So enable the possibility that different services, different providers can interoperate, like it is now perfectly normal in the Italian situation.
Okay, Hector, how does the Spanish landscape is configured in this way?
I wish I could say you it's similar to the first one, but the reality is we are more likely in the second scenario that Igor commented. The reality is that we have no regulation further than public to private notifications. So in the case that two private parties want to notificate each other, they are using what we call a third trust party.
Okay.
This is a provider that is giving a service super similar to an e-delivery. So through an SMS or through an email, they are certifying a communication, but as it's not based on a trust service like eDelivery, it has not all the benefits of a trust service. So right now we are moving to this third trust parties to an eDelivery provided by a trust service provider.
Oh, nice. I believe that this kind of system is very similar to France, right?
Yeah, indeed. In France, it is called Lettre Recommandée Electronique. Uh-huh. It's more or less a store and notify solution with a specific local regulation that gives the same legal value of a notification. So if you want to notify someone in France, you can use that kind of system.
But let me understand, Igor. Why Can't I just use an email or a WhatsApp? I know the hour. I know when, with a double check, the blue double check on WhatsApp, for example, to read the message, when the recipient read the message. How it's working different with the e-delivery?
It's a matter of liability. It's a matter of certainty. It's a matter of certification of it. You know, eIDAS gives us two different levels, two different configurations. The electronic register delivery service that is provided by a trust service provider, so a provider that shall follow certain standards, shall give some, has a liability for it, but it's not qualified. Okay. The other one is the qualified electronic register delivery services. You know, during this podcast, the word qualified has been, pops out quite often. And this means that from a qualified, you have even the identification of the sender, of the receiver, with a different level of trust and certainty. TSPs and QTSPs takes the liability of this communication. Sure. I think that the simple email messaging or SMS or WhatsApp cannot do. These are technical solutions that can enable any delivery solution. So okay. What does eIDAS adds to the communication? A liability scheme. A liability scheme that can permit to the sender and the receiver to be sure of what happened, who sent it, when has been sent it, with legal validity and proofs that can even be produced before for a judge to decide in a business situation.
So I cannot go in front of the judge with just a simple email and be sure that can be used during a procedure.
You can, sure. But you do not have the certainty that a clear liability scheme will be applied to that.
So Hector, coming back to you, which are the advantages, benefits and use cases that we can unlock thanks to e-delivery harmonized in all Europe?
We can find thousands of examples. No? As Igor said, sometimes there are some procedures that you have respect sometimes, so due dates, not that, and this is where e-delivery service have their part. So let me call a funny example. We can go back to 2015. If we have any soccer fan, they will remind for sure this example. Real Madrid tried to hire a Manchester United goalkeeper, David De Gea. So they have all the agreement, all the numbers, the contract was signed, everything was closed. The only part missing was to formally notify to the club, to Manchester United, this agreement. No, so a fax was sent to the club. The only problem is that this fax was delivered couple minutes after the period was closed. So all the contract was broken. This for sure will be solved with an e-delivery service and by the provider, by a trust service provider.
Wow, this is so funny. I don't want to be in the shoes of the lawyer that were sending the
Not at all. I don't think they got a good day that day.
Exactly. They have no a good day. One last question. What about sustainability?
Yeah, of course. You know, e-delivery is electronic. So just for the fact of being electronic, you save paper, yes, you save time, you save kilometers of the postal person that shall deliver physical paper. Of course, you need to cope these benefits with the choice of the provider. A provider that shall be ESG compliant, so with a strategy, sure, in environmental, social, and governance. So, a provider that uses green energy and is careful on with a really low impact on the environment. So, the ecological footprint should be really, really important and taken into consideration by the providers.
So absolutely. What do you think about?
At the end, it's not just ESG, which is so important. For example, in the case of Italy and with the PEC, we can find that more than 100,000 tons of CO2 was saved with the application
of PEC. Just in 1 year, I believe.
And more than 400,000 million kilometers were not driven. So it's not just this ESG matter, it's also economic impact on the companies. Why? Because if we go to the postal, you have to print, you have to physically deliver it. So this digitalization also saves money. This SMS process, sending an SMS, sending an email through an e-delivery service, saves huge costs to the companies also.
So we can easily say more eDelivery for everyone.
Totally.
So thank you very much, Hector, for being with us. Thank you very much, Igor. We will see in the next episode, of course. And thanks especially all of you for watching us. I just remind you that you can watch all the episode on our YouTube channel or listening to it through your favorite podcast platform. Thank you very much and have a good day.